Hello and welcome to another update video about LINK. The LINK chart continues to be in this five-wave pattern to the upside that we call a leading diagonal, or some kind of a diagonal at least, in my opinion, a leading diagonal in a wave one. So we've got a wave one, a wave two, a wave three, a wave four, and a wave five. The wave five is obviously still missing. I'd really like to see that fifth wave targeting $20.90+. That would be ideal. To get there, support needs to hold at $9.50. $9.75 is the last reliable Fibonacci support, but we did say we want to use the 950 level as key support because that's basically the breakout point. Previous breakout point, price might never get there, yeah, but it's just I would say, you know, because the price did spend so much time in this messy structure here, and 950 is really the key level here, plus minus a few cents, you know, but a break above that level really indicated a phase change in the market. And therefore we said, okay, as long as we stay above that level, we have at least some, you know, bullish momentum. Also, we can identify a parallel price channel in which the price is moving. So you see that here, if I take that out and take that line out as well, just to show you a bit clarity here on the chart. So you see here this parallel trend channel, and the price could still get there. I mean, there's no need, but this is the support area. And as long as it's holding, I would expect a fifth wave to the upside. We have to give, however, a chart certain space, you know, in the markets, also in an uptrend. I mean, this could turn into a five wave pattern. It's a so-called motive wave. It moves in the direction of the larger trend. So the five waves up would give us a first confirmation that possibly here a lasting low was indeed established here in June, before then a deeper pullback occurs. If that pullback is holding a higher low and is a corrective pullback, okay, so there will be certain things in the structure we're gonna look for, then the third wave should really escalate higher. And that would be a real bull run in a third wave, only if certain conditions will be met, but we will talk about them when we get there. But we have to give it, obviously, also in this trend, let's say progressing structure, we also need to give it space. So it's breathing in, breathing out, right? In an uptrend, it's a little bit more breathing in, but it also needs to breathe out in these corrections. And only the market knows where exactly it will land, but we can identify the areas where, in terms of probabilities, you know, the market should turn around. So we've got $12.88, $11.04, $9.75. And it hasn't even, well, it reached here the first FIB level, okay? And then we highlighted, okay, we might get a high corrective wave, which we did. And now we're coming down, and my best reading is that this is an ABC structure, but it's also not coming down as an impulse, really. So just be prepared for wave count changes. This is a pretty messy structure here. So we have to just prepare ourselves for potential wave count changes and, you know, changes in the scenario. There are many ways, you know, how this correction could really unfold, from a simple ABC structure to maybe even a more complex, WXY, possibly even a WXY within the Y wave here. At the moment, I'm still labeling that as an ABC in wave Y, but that might change. It's entirely possible that this B wave is getting a bit of a reset higher. But the key is, there are many ways how this could evolve. Even a triangle is possible. I mean, that's something we haven't really explored in detail. For example, a fourth wave can be a triangle. A wave, B wave, high B wave, possible in triangles as well. The C wave, as long as we don't break below the $12.88 level, this could be the C wave of the triangle, then another D and E. So if it's forming next a lower high and then a higher low, we've got a triangle, but then I would watch for a breakout after that. We know that LINK likes to move in sideways structures. Okay, obviously it spent more than a year into this year in this channel down there. So just be aware of that. You know, we have to wait for a first clear signal that the wave five has started from an analysis point of view. From a trader point of view, you might choose to scale in, yeah, because you will only know afterwards. You know, bottom line is the analysis tells you it will take quite a while before we know that this fifth wave has started. Think about what that might mean for you and your portfolio and position. If you want to get into a position, what does that mean? It will take quite a while. Why? Because we're dealing with a diagonal, and in the diagonal, the fifth wave is an ABC structure. The ABC could be an ABC in itself. Very difficult to identify the subwave structures, or at least it will not be reliable. So if you want to get a position, I've got my grid bot running, but if you might just want to get a position, you might want to decide to scale in. Now you have to make that decision for yourself, right? When do you start? Depending on your risk profile, we know that $9.50 is support. So we have to give it a lot of space. So position size would need to be small, but if we dip deeper into support, might get a little bit larger. My preferred target would still be $11 because it's the 38.2 retracement, the ideal target for a fourth wave, but we might never get there, okay? The key is the longer such a correction takes time-wise, the less deep it needs to be, because corrections can, you know, the price can correct over time or just via the price, okay? So it can basically come down quite quickly and it's a correction, or it could just spend a lot of time in sideways movement. So at any point, I will try to give you my best view of what the structure is like at the moment. I haven't got a really good view of what this bit is, but we haven't taken out the previous B wave high. So it takes a break above 1561 to suggest that this B wave is extending or that even the fifth wave is already starting, which I would need more evidence for. So yeah, situation hasn't really changed. Still watching for that fifth wave. No evidence it has started yet. Target for the fifth wave around $20.90 plus. Yeah, that's my update about LINK. Hope you liked the update. If you did, please hit the like button, leave a comment and subscribe. And if you really like the content, then please check out the channel membership. Also, make sure that you follow us on Instagram and Twitter for additional content. Thanks a lot for watching. Bye-bye.